This is my pet. Hello. Ah. Hey guys, how are you doing? I'm going to do a feeding video of this species because, well, if you want to breed them, unfortunately, the death head hawk moths do not eat on its own. So when they're adult, you need to hand feed them. I found a way to feed them, and I'm going to show you how to do that because it would have helped me to see it and to have someone to explain to me. So here we go. Thank you for watching. So what will you need to feed your death head hawk moth? You will need honey, whatever type of honey is fine. You will need water. You will need a bowl. You will need either a little lid or something quite shallow. I like to put something in there, so that's like a metal bowl, whatever you call this, so that this stays in place. Depending on how you want to feed them, you either use this or you will use that. So this is a small syringe that I have cut the end so that the moth can put his tongue in there and then drink from the syringe. So I'm going to show you first this way. So what you want to do is to mix honey with water, one part of honey with one part of water. I've already done that in there. Then you will need toothpick. Don't use a pin because that can hurt your death head hawk moth. You want to put some honey in the little plate, the little lid, whatever you use, up. Ah shit! This is magnetic. Okay, let's put that here. Okay, I'm gonna put more. I'm gonna put it from far. So that's okay. So that should be Okay, stay there. Stay in there. Okay, fine. Now you need a moth. So mine will seems much more tame than yours. If it's the first time that you feed them, you're gonna struggle. They're not gonna like that. But once they have actually tasted the honey, they should calm down and start to feed. If they are not doing that, it means that they are not that hungry. So this one is used to be fed, so it should not be too difficult. But what you want to do is to actually take your moth and catch it in your hand like this, so that only the head come back. Then you take your little pick, and this is the tricky part. So you want to put the pick just below the eyes so that you can unroll their tongue. So that's the tricky part because they don't like it. They should squeak, so they're gonna make noise when you do that. Mines are used to it, so they don't really make noise anymore. But then, okay, so you take your tongue, and the tongue, you dip it inside the honey. And once you have done that, as you can see, it starts to feed, so he's happy. Now, okay, so he's gonna try to feed from the plate. Okay, and then you can leave it. But this is not the method that I prefer to use because I don't really see how much they're eating that way. I'm gonna show you another method to feed them. I don't really like using this method because usually they go in the plate and they put a mess, there is honey everywhere, they're all messy, and yeah, so it's not great. But this one is behaving quite well. He's not, he just have his one of his legs inside the honey, so it's fine. He's drinking like crazy. Okay, so he's hungry. Oh, he's got antenna stuck. Oh, come on. Voila, you are happy like this. So you need to feed them approximately once every
3 days. I would say 2 days. It's better when they are not eating. Usually, they are going to either mate or they are going to lay eggs. So this one is a female, so she's probably not gonna make any eggs today, but she will make them tomorrow. And that's all for feeding them with this plate. So it takes time, as you can see, they can feed for up to 5 minutes. She was very hungry. Oh, I'm gonna try to turn her a little bit. Oh no, I disturbed her. Okay, come on, eat more. You should eat more. Tuk. Voilà. She's so used to it that I just need to unroll her tongue and she starts eating again. So the other method to feed them, and the one that I actually use, is with a syringe. So I'm gonna put the syringe here. Oh, you don't see. Right. Okay, so I take the mouth the same way, like this. They're very used again, so when you're gonna do that, if it's the first time, they're not gonna be as nice as mine. And then I unroll the tongue and I put it inside the syringe. That way, the advantage with that way is that I can see how much they're drinking, because I will have to push to put the level of honey up, and so I know exactly how much they've drunk. While when they are in the lead and they drink from by themselves, I don't really know how much they're drinking. Well, I don't know if you can see, but she's... Okay, that takes much longer, that takes much more time, because if you want to feed several at once, you can't. Unless you have 4 arms, but usually we don't have four arms. Okay, I'm not so sure, but she's not drinking. Sometimes they drink very quickly, sometimes they don't. The first feed, usually they drink quite a lot, but... Okay, come on. So if you're not willing to do that, there's no point to breed this species, because they are not gonna eat by their own. They will need to be fed, so... Okay. Okay, she's not hungry anymore, apparently. Thank you for watching, and subscribe, and let me know if you have any questions, and I will answer, and like my video, or dislike it, or do whatever you want, and I'll see you another time, and no, actually, you're gonna see me. And that's all. Yeah. She's happy. Ah! No, don't fly away! Come back here! Okay, bye!